Hey, hello everyone. I'm going to be doing a special little Skyward Sword series here. I'll explain as I go. This is going to have some probably big spoilers for the game because I am going to be doing the sixth dungeon here. This is going to be completely and totally blind. Now you'll notice that it is a black screen right now, so if you don't want to see the sixth dungeon and anything ahead of that, like after I beat the boss and see the continuity of the story, you best leave now. Anyway, let's get this started. Now you'll see that I am at the entrance to the dungeon. I just wanted to make sure that I was actually at the dungeon, but I have not played this before, ever. So, this is going to be a series on why I don't play games blind on my channel. That looks very hot. I haven't seen anything more than this little thing just to make sure I was entering the dungeon, you know, because this place has a lot of transitions to new areas and stuff like that. For all I knew, this was taking me to a new underground place, not a dungeon. It's just how a Skyward Sword works, so this is all I've seen, this is all I know of, I'm in the Fire Sanctuary. And now, the reason why I'm doing this series is for a couple reasons, actually. Between the fact that I just seem to have, like, more fun lately playing Kirby than I have been Skyward Sword, and this game has not really been holding my interest very well, and yeah, I haven't actually been able to finish this. It's like, well, would I prefer to play Kirby today, or do I want to play some Skyward Sword? No, I want to play some Kirby! So that's one of the reasons why I am doing this little video series, is to keep, or I should say, to continue playing this game. For some reason, I just can't tell why right now. It's just so hard to explain. It's just not holding my interest. And there's clearly nothing here, is there? I'm just slashing some grass for the heck of it as I'm explaining stuff. And the other reason why is to show exactly why I don't do blind runs on games. Because as soon as a game is released or it's about to be released, people immediately start asking me, "Hey, PkGam, you're going to be doing a walkthrough on Skyward Sword? Hey, PkGam, you're going to be doing a walkthrough on Kirby's Return to Dreamland?" Yeah, immediately. Wait, that? I was expecting to be able to cut that. Let me try that again. I think I slightly missed that. Can I cut this? I'm not sure if I can cut this. It doesn't look like I can cut that. Okay, I don't really see any other way around this room, unless I'm like able to cut other ones and they have stuff inside there. But no, I guess that doesn't work. But yeah, this is basically why I don't do things blind, because I don't know what I can do, and it'll take much longer to finish a walkthrough than it would be had I just, you have to actually hit into it with the beetle. Oh, okay. Normally you have to cut things with that beetle, so that kind of threw me for a loop there. But I knew I had to do something with that, it just seemed too suspicious. And what was that? Was that like water inside these plants or something like that? That made that thing? See, that's another thing that I don't know when I do a blind run, is that, yeah, there's definitely water inside the plants. I seen a splash on the ground there. Anyway, now I'm going to attempt to do this entire dungeon blind on camera, and it is going to be, or very likely to be, a disaster. I'm going to make this as if I were making the walkthrough up to this point. So it's like, I'm not going to be explaining any controls, I'm not going to be delving into parts of this, well, because I don't know parts of the story just yet. So please don't spoil that for me as well as others, you know, that haven't played this game before. Remember that this game is still fairly new, so respect other people's wishes not to have that game spoiled to them. And why couldn't I make that jump? That lava is, it's got a current to it. Okay, I get it. So I have to do, see, this is a kind of thing that I wouldn't have made a mistake on if I would have done this, you know, not blind. Now it's gonna come towards me, and then I'll be able to make the jump over to this side. There we go. And how far does this thing reach out to? Does it keep, like, floating down that path? Or does it eventually burn up? Well, those guys are calling their buddies over. Yeah, that thing just keeps floating on, doesn't it? Okay, that's another mistake I would have known if I had played this game before. Because I wouldn't have, I would have realized that I should have stayed on ye old lava raft here that I create by hitting this thing. And obviously I don't have a key just yet, so, oh, I need to get out my bow, don't I? Yeah, I'm just gonna get that out and attempt to snipe these suckers as I go along. Oh, reload, Link. Oh, I'm out of fire. Oh, I'm out of arrows. No! I didn't notice that. Well, this is awkward. Hopefully I'll be able to take care of him or them in general when I get to the other side. Yeah, I'll probably be able to get him from the other side. How far does this... I'm probably gonna have to get off here. Okay. And, wow, he died fast. And, okay. Probably because my sword is much more powered up than it used to be, thanks to those sacred flame thingies. Anyway, they keep calling for more peeps, and they aren't getting any. maybe they are getting some, I'm not sure. Needless to say, I'm just doing some basic horizontal slashes. If you know the controls of this game, you know that the sword follows the Wii Motion Plus thing, which is a pretty neato thing. You got your vertical slashes, both directions, right, left, stuff like that is pretty cool. Oh, and the spin attack is done with by shaking both them at the same time in any direction you want to. And that gauge there is your run meter. Why am I explaining this? I told you I wouldn't explain this sort of stuff. What does this give me? A key! And I bet you that opens the door that's right down there. Yes! Okay, what? Oh, you? Wait. You're different than what I was expecting. I was expecting one of those mole-like critters. There's this mole-like critter that keeps following you through the game. I don't know his name offhand. And he was the guy that helped or gave me a bomb bag earlier. You should know who he is. I'm on a quest, man. I don't know what I'll get if I say either of the answers. Gold? No. Well, that's nice. Yeah, the digging mitts are things that you can use to dig up those odd X-shaped holes on the ground that looks like that something is buried underneath there. Great! I'll be glad to see what's killing off all these critters. yeah, pretty much. Two statues that face one another? Jump into the mouth of the sleeping statue. I should probably write this down. hold on. Okay, I'm good. I wrote it down because, as you guys know, I have pretty bad memory. And that is not good for a blind run, so I'm just gonna take out the guesswork that I'll probably end up doing later if I don't write that down and just do that now. I suppose I could probably just, like, come back here and talk to that guy again. Are we going outside? Anyway, I could talk to him again if I wanted to see what he has to say. Yeah, we are going outside. Okay. Anyway, back on the whole, this game isn't holding my interest thing. As I said, I just don't know why. Maybe it's just because this is the first time that I've ever had, like, two major release games so close together, because I had, like, Kirby's Return to Dream Land and Zelda Skyward Sword. So I'm, like, maybe it's because I'm, like, able to compare the fun factor that I'm having with the games, and in this case, Kirby is just... I'm just having a lot more fun with Kirby. Don't let those things hit you, you won't be able to use your sword, and that'll suck. Or any item, actually, for that matter. Wait, what is that? Oh, he was stuck in that corner. That window, or whatever the heck that was. Is that a window? It looks like some sort of window. Either that, or it's like a, I don't know, torch pedestal thing. No, yo, no. Okay. I just don't want to lose access to my sword, because that's very sucky. Oh, dang it, stop calling for your buddies. No, I am slashing randomly, and I shouldn't be doing that. I should be paying more attention to how I am attacking. Is there really nothing more in here? I find that hard to believe. Torch? Yeah, that's just a little alcove to... I mean, for the torches, they aren't windows at all, so a bat just got stuck there for the heck of it. Well, it's a keys, but yeah. Some sort of, like, shadow keys. I don't know their name offhand. I don't really feel like checking them with the goddess, which may I add, your goddess friend right here is, I guess I can't really show her now. She's a pretty freaky girl. She gives off this really odd vibe, I have to say. I don't know if that's a good or bad thing. Because, you know, she's seemingly on your side. I don't know if she's going to turn on you later or something like that. That would be quite the twist, I would have to say, you know, considering that she's helped you throughout the entire game. But she freaks me out a little. what is this? I don't know. If I jump down here, can I get back up? Because I don't want to do stuff until I can come back through there. And I don't have arrows to shoot through. Wait, I do have arrows now, because I got some stuff from the... But do I want to shoot this? Something tells me that doesn't help me in the slightest. Alright, let's just jump down here blindly and... Okay, oh, wait, what the heck? Is that lava? Oh my god, it is following me! It's a lava hand of some sort. Okay, let's see if I can defeat it just for the fun of it. I don't know if I can or not. What is it anyway? Magmanos? Maybe it's a different version of a blarg or something like that. So I could hurt it if I probably have to douse it with water or something like it, or something like that. Like with those water plants. Because I definitely don't have anything that can freeze it. Ow, that I know of. No. I would like to run away from you at the moment. Actually, is there anything in this room that I can use? I'm not seeing anything. And again, this is where the blind run factor comes into effect. Like, for all I know, I'm able to access these things somehow, but I just don't know how at the moment. And I know I can't shoot my beetle through these bars. I can shoot arrows through the bars. I didn't see any claw shot targets in this room, unless I'm able to grasp onto those torches or something like that, as I could do in Ocarina of Time. I guess I could give that a shot. I'm not close enough, am I? Okay, I'm gonna bait him out, because he's definitely following me. It's kind of hard, it's kind of tricky to get him to do what you want. Am I safe on here? I'd like to hope that I'm safe on here. And I'm too close to... it doesn't matter, I can't grab onto them anyway. Ugh. Oh, wait, did that... Oh, he just pushed me up on the thing. I just found that accidentally. Delightful, okay, push me up. Puzzle solved! So I guess I need his assistance to get through this. Wah! More arrows. They probably won't help me in the slightest. Well, okay, they probably will later. But what? I can climb on that a little later. I see a guy that I can kill off now. Ooh-ah. Oh, don't move. I would like to kill you. There you go. The sweet release of death is a lot better than shooting me, that's for sure. And I love how Link is a lot more agile in this game than he is in other ones. Like, you can just do these little hip-hops as you're going up. As you're going up climbing things just by shaking the Wii remote, that is a nice little addition, as well as the ability to run in general by holding the A button. As I said, I just don't understand why this game isn't holding my interest. It's definitely a very good game. I just don't know. Oh, and you can even move. I mean, yeah, you can even move while you're shooting with the bow. So that's another great addition, because of the fact that you are able to dodge enemy attacks rather than just being a sitting duck along the way. See, they improved so much on the Zelda formula, and I'm going to run out of... Oh, no, I'm not, as long as I don't do that little dashy-dash thing. Okay. But, yeah, I think it's just because of the fact that I'm just having so much fun playing Kirby, and... Yeah. I do want to play this game, but it's like when I want to play video games, it's like, which one do I choose? Well, I'm still in the mood to play Kirby, and that's just what I aim to do. Alright, save place, but I like ended up combining both words at the same time. Okay, what I'm gonna do is end off the part here, because there's a save point, and it's about like 16 minutes or so, which is a good part length as I would normally make in a walkthrough. So, I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next blind part.